It's Wednesday, so you know
we're winging it. Today we're visiting with Joel and Deb. You might know them as Chasing RV Sunshine. So we're going to find out how they are chasing RV sunshine on this week's Wingin' It.
Hey, y'all, welcome back. I'm Stacy.
I'm Tom, and we're RV Texas, y'all.
We are Native Texans and full-time RVers who are all about exploring the great state of Texas and beyond, one campground at a time. We're on a mission to experience life, not just live it, and we're bringing you along for the fun.
In 2018, we sold our house, our business, and got rid of most everything we owned to hit the road and see America. Our home is a 33-foot RV named Freedom. We installed an extreme solar and lithium setup, so now we can just about live anywhere with our dog Star and our cat Astro.
Every day is a new adventure, so join us as we RV America, y'all.
Okay, before we get started, let's quickly review the rules of Wingin' It. We set the timer on my phone for 15 minutes since we're with friends. We talk about the topic, their journey, and when the timer goes off, we wrap things up. This is completely unedited, unscripted,
and you get what you get.
So, 15 minutes on the clock. We're Wingin' It. And we got the help of the Grackles today.
Yeah, we do.
You might hear them in the background.
We're here at beautiful Jamaica Beach.
And this is January, and it's a little cooler than it was last week, but not bad, huh?
It's been pretty awesome, hasn't it?
Yes. It has been. We're from Wisconsin, so this is amazing.
No snow on the ground. It can be whatever temperature it wants to be.
That's awesome. One of the first questions that I want to ask is, and I kind of know the answer to it, but I think the audience would like to know, how did you come about the name of your channel? Because I think that's a very interesting story.
Well, if you start following us, you'll find this out a lot. There was beer involved. We are from Wisconsin. We love our beer and we love our cheese. But we had been trying to come up with some names, and we are both retired law enforcement. And so
thank you for that.
Yes, you're welcome. We're enjoying retirement. But the chasing came in from, we've always been chasing the bad guys and stuff down our whole careers. So now let's find something positive to do. Let's chase sunshine, because you can't control the weather and you can't control bad days, but you can always find sunshine.
I love it.
So then we ended up adding the word RV in between, and now we are chasing RV sunshine.
That's awesome.
Yeah. That's so awesome. And we do see a lot of retired police and military. I think that's probably the predominantly thing we see full-time out on the road. And that's all. It makes us even feel safer while we're out there, too.
Yeah, absolutely. So you guys are new to RVing, and you're new to full-time.
Right.
Yes.
How did this all come about?
Well, many years ago, we were on vacation with some friends. The idea of RVing came up, and after dinner, we were heading back to our hotel, and I'm like, I think we could do that when we retire. Now, that was many years ago. That was almost 20 years ago.
Yeah.
So then, as we got closer to retirement, we started talking about it, and we kind of came up with a five-year plan that, hey, we're going to do this, so we better plan for it. So we started watching YouTube and you guys and a few others, and kind of just took our steps and slowly started buying some of the stuff that, you know, we knew we were going to need, and then started researching what rig we were going to get. So we kind of planned for it.
Yeah.
Did you go to RV shows and that kind of stuff to see different RVs?
We sure did. We lived close to Minneapolis-St. Paul, only about an hour away, so we went over to the shows over there a few times and would catch some locally and whatnot and walk through rigs. So we didn't know when we first started whether it was going to be a towable, a fifth wheel, or a Class A or Class C or whatever. And we finally narrowed it down a couple years ago, and then narrowed it down to the rig we currently have.
Let's let everybody know what it is.
It is a 2018 Tiffin Allegro Red 33AA.
Which is a diesel pusher,
it's a
shorter diesel pusher. Yeah.
Correct. It's 35 feet, so just perfectly. We wanted something smaller so we could get in and out of places a little better and hopefully get into some of the national parks that people talked about the bigger rigs couldn't get into.
Right. So isn't that, though, you talked about, you know, kind of looking at all the different types of RVs. For us, that's always been the biggest challenge, is narrowing down what was going to be right for us. to travel in, because there are so many choices, and it's different. Everybody's needs and wants are different.
Yeah, and the early on, we found out that we were never going to find everything we wanted in a room. And then the different model numbers and whether they have bunks or don't have bunks, and there's just so much out there that you just got to kind of take your time and figure out what your priorities are going to be and go with it.
Yep. Yeah, absolutely. So you had your plan, and I think that's smart that you did all your research and you kind of did your shopping over a period of time so you didn't feel rushed.
Right. And you bought new. I mean, you bought used, too.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah.
So how did that decision come about? Because that's a whole nother thing. Right. I mean, your first RV, you decided to buy used.
Yeah. Yep. We had, like I said, we had been looking for, at this point, it was over a year, and that was December of 2019. And we could not find, we had narrowed it down to the Tiffin 33AA.
Okay.
And we could not find a used one. And we were just contacting some places, and we decided we were going to order new. And I went on RV Trader and ended up seeing this rig. He was at work, and I called the owner, and he is an 85-year-old gentleman in Florida. And we talked for an hour.
Oh, wow.
And he came home, and I was on the treadmill, and I turned around and said, I found our rig. We're going to have to fly to Florida.
Sure, it was a surprise to me, because we had already talked about we were going to order. So yeah. Then I came home, and she's like, I found it. And then we booked a trip.
We're going to Florida.
Yeah, yep. And we did. And
we did.
Talked to the gentleman and a super nice guy and couple, and he had to, for health reasons, they were going to have to quit. So we ended up buying it, and he didn't want us driving it back into Wisconsin during the winter, so he offered to store it in Florida for free until until spring came.
Yep.
So
yep.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
That's a neat story.
Yeah.
Well, then we had an 11-day trip planned starting April 4th of 2020. And on like March 26th, we both got put on travel bans from our work. So we couldn't fly down to Florida or leave the state or travel anywhere. So luckily, Joel found a company out of Eau Claire that flew down and had our rig back in Wisconsin within 24 hours for us.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
So
they flew out early Saturday morning, and they had it back to us Sunday afternoon.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yep.
So they brought it to you. Was that a very expensive process, or?
Well, I like to think it was cheaper than the 11-day trip that we had.
So, yeah, that's a good way to think of it.
That's a good way to think of it.
Yeah, luckily we found a local company, and they, you know, one of the guys flew down there and drove it back. So it was less expensive. I was researching getting, you know, regular companies that do it for a living, and it was going to be about $4,000, and I ended up with this company doing it for less than two. So
okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not bad.
Yeah.
And they took good care of it, obviously.
Excellent. Excellent. Not a thing wrong, and that included the gas. I didn't have to pay for the gas either.
Nice.
Just did
yeah.
It as a one lump sum. So
that's nice. Really neat. That's awesome. And another thing we've noticed on y'all's channel, and I think you guys will be very interested in and checking their channel out, is they share a lot of their expenses, which I know people that are looking to go full time.
Or even travel for extended periods.
Yeah, that they really want to know what those expenses are. And that's awesome that you guys share those expenses and stuff.
Yeah, how did you, so you're still new to full-timing. So how did you kind of come up with your initial budget? How did y'all brainstorm to kind of figure out where you wanted to be with that?
Yeah, so we decided to share our budget because that was one of the things that I was big on early on is, are we going to be able to afford it, you
right.
know, initially just on my retirement. So we did a lot of research, and we didn't find a lot of people sharing the real numbers. You know, they shared parts of the numbers or whatever, which I totally understand. Money's a personal thing. But that's why we decided to do it. But we just looked at our expenses that were in the house, and we figured many of them were going to be the same, like how we eat and things like that. It was fuel and all that other stuff, the camping costs or stuff that we had to figure out. So I was just watching other YouTubes because some of them did share, so that was good. And then we just decided that we're going to make a budget and fit within it.
Okay. Yep. And I saw on one of your videos where you talk about your budget, you went over on restaurants, which I was not surprised by at all.
No.
Yeah.
We understand that one totally.
Because to me, one of the perks of being able to travel everywhere is, I call it living like a local, and being able to try some of the little mom and pop mm-hmm. restaurants that are unique to that area.
Yeah.
So we probably eat out more now than we did when we were living in the house.
But it's part of our budget now.
Right.
And we talked about that because we have found that Wisconsin, we lived in a smaller community in Chippewa Falls area, which is wonderful and everyone should travel to in the summer. Oh, in the winter, it's cold and snow. But the pricing wise there for restaurants and stuff were way cheaper than what it is as we have been traveling.
Okay.
And so that has to come into play, obviously, in our budget. But we're also finding exactly we want to try some more of the local stuff and finding a local and telling us this is the restaurant to go to and
ask
then go try that. But we have realized that we are going to have to up our restaurant budget for sure.
Well, and you know what? That's a great point, the prices being different, because we grew up in Houston.
Yeah.
So for us, when we get into some of those smaller towns, we're like, wow, this is really inexpensive to be able to eat. You know, so yeah, it's all what you're used to and where you are. Everywhere is different.
Yeah. And we're learning that as we travel, that some places are great and then others are definitely touristy. And then that automatically, I think, adds like $5 to the plate of food.
That's exactly right.
Sure.
So what are some of your, you've been to a lot of places already in a short period of time. You guys actually went full time when? When did you move into the RV?
We moved into the RV June 1st of 2021. Our house had just sold. We were both still working, so we lived in the RV full time while we were working until we retired in October and then hit the road October 4th.
Okay.
So this is
basically
January
4th.
Right?
So this
months.
Is a nomadiversary for you guys.
Yeah, this is 6 months.
From when we moved
when
in
we
full
moved
time.
That's
so
cool.
Congratulations.
Well,
yeah.
Thank you.
What are some of your, I guess, what's one of the challenges that you've faced so far since being in the rig full time? Has there been anything that kind of just jumped out at you and you
that
went,
you
yeah,
didn't
I did not
expect
that?
That you didn't expect?
Well, it's once again the when we go to the grocery store, obviously everything is like a completely different layout, so there's some change and nuances to that where it's like all of a sudden instead of taking, you know, a half hour to shop, it takes us an hour because we're trying to find everything and then find a different brand. Obviously, I feel bad for the whole entire rest of the country without the lack of cheese selections.
I guess that's true. You guys are used to cheese.
Okay, yes.
And we love cheese.
And fresh cheese and cheese curds. You guys are missing out.
Oh, man. That's a reason to go to Wisconsin
right
there.
Yeah. Well, and we had heard, you know, on YouTube about different grocery stores, and it's, you know, so we were kind of prepared for it, but it was definitely a challenge because everything's in a different spot. You don't find your brands. The name brands are different or whatever. So we just make it a journey for the day.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
And like we say on our channel, the journey is the destination. It's part of the journey.
It is.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it is part of the journey. I mean, we embrace it now. It's like we go to a store. We know we're going to be there longer.
Right.
It's just,
right.
We budget more time,
right.
Basically.
And one thing we did just learn about, too, which they're absolutely fabulous, is the HEB and their hot tortillas.
Welcome to Texas.
Yes.
Welcome
I mean, those
Texas.
Are amazing.
They are amazing.
And like, and we just went to our first Buc-ee's too.
Okay. Yeah, you're just taking
all these
it all,
great
man.
Texas things.
Yes.
You're learning.
We are. And I said, Buc-ee's is large.
Yeah.
It is large. And they have every kind of jerky except beaver. Because Buc-ee is a beaver.
Right.
So
yes.
So, okay, so and now that's one of your challenges. What's one of your favorite things so far that you guys have done or been to or discovered since you've been traveling?
Yeah, so far I think it's the different foods. We found out that we absolutely love oysters on the half shell, which we've never really had before.
And they're the best, right?
They are great. I'll tell you what, we've had a bunch of them since we've been here and around. And when we were in Gulf Shores, we had a bunch too. Mm-hmm. So I think just different types of foods. And we've always been foodies, so to speak. But being able to try all this stuff. And again, local stuff if we can.
Yeah. And we did just first have our first, what do we think? Tamales.
Oh, okay.
What'd you think about that?
Loved that.
Yes. I mean, everybody knows we've even featured tamales on our channel. We love tamales.
Yeah.
Yes, they were really good.
Yep.
Friends of ours had come down from Houston to say hi and had stopped at apparently where the best place in Houston has tamales.
Or one of them, I'm guessing.
And brought them. So we just had those. Oh, they were good.
They were excellent.
Oh, yeah. Nice. And, you know, we tell folks there's a, we are in Galveston at Jamaica Beach, you know, kind of our winter home. There's a lady and her family that normally drives through on Saturday afternoons here in the park selling fresh tamales that she makes in her home. And we always say, you know, if you're around here, if you're in Texas, and a lady drives up selling tamales out of her car, the answer is yes.
We haven't seen her.
Again, another local thing you wouldn't know about.
Exactly.
So now, how is the rig working out for you guys? I know you went to Red Bay recently and had your first
experience. They had the Red Bay experience.
We did. We had a list, and it wasn't anything major. There was a paneling on the wall that was coming apart, and we had a leaky water filter. So there's nothing major we wanted done, but we wanted to go there, and then we also went to Bay Diesel to have the services
Aren't
done.
Aren't they fantastic?
Oh, they are absolutely fantastic.
Incredible.
So, the experience was, you know, first come, first serve, like they always tell you. So hurry up and wait. But that's, again, we found some local things to do. And
Rattlesnake Saloon.
And they actually have a video on that, too.
Yeah.
Well, we'll put a link down in the description. But
what I wanted to ask,
that went fast.
Now,
who drives the rig?
Mainly Joel. I have driven. I drove prior to having our tow vehicle attached and stuff, but I did drive for the first time between Livingston, Texas and Austin.
Okay.
And that had, I mean, it was all set up with the tow vehicle, and at minute about 10, we're at a stoplight and he's like, watch for this, watch for that. And all of a sudden I realized I'm driving our whole house with everything in it, and started panicking. And I'm like, oh my gosh, if I do something wrong or whatever, this is our whole house. And he's like, he looks over and he's like, are you crying? And I'm like, no. And ended up getting on the highway, and finally, about after an hour, I got up over 45. But I said it was driving comfortable, and finally I got relaxed, and I said it was just fine.
Yeah.
So I'll drive again. But I said that recall, I'm like, that was a bad time to realize that I was driving everything.
No pressure.
No pressure. We've always been defensive drivers, and that's what you really need to be when you're driving a rig. Is
right.
Be as defensive as you can. Drive your own speed that you're comfortable with.
Don't
safety first.
In a hurry.
Right.
There's no reason to be in a hurry full time.
Now, have you, and I know we've passed our 15 minutes, but hang with us here, because I have a couple questions I think are interesting as new full-timers. Have you guys kind of settled in on what a drive day looks like how far you go? Do you have a certain distance or a certain period of time that you drive between locations, or how do you decide that?
Yeah, we have definitely figured that out, because when we left Red Bay, we went to meet friends in the Gulf Shores, and that was an eight-hour day. We are not doing that again.
No.
Yeah.
That is like, if there's emergency situation, stuff like that, yes, we can do it. But we like 3 to 5 hours.
Yeah.
And that's about it. And want to leave about 10 and get somewhere before 3 o'clock so that we're ready for cocktails at 5.
Right. There
that,
you go.
That we agree with that philosophy.
And like everybody says, you don't want to be setting up in the dark, if at all possible.
No,
you don't
exactly
want to pull
right.
into a campground in the dark.
Nope.
And y'all do, you said you tow a car. You tow four wheels down, correct?
We do, correct.
Yes.
Yep.
What are y'all towing?
We're towing a 2015 Ford Edge.
Okay.
Which, there's a story behind that, because you didn't know necessarily if that was going to be towable initially, right?
Yeah, so everybody was saying, well, you can't tow it. It's an all-wheel drive vehicle. You can't flat tow it. You can't flat tow it. Well, I finally went to the manual, and 2015 was the first year you could flat tow that vehicle. So,
and you happen to have a 2015.
Right.
Woo-hoo!
So we were happy with that. We didn't have to go out and purchase another vehicle, because we had been planning on getting a Jeep.
Yeah.
And when this one goes, that's what we'll get. But for the meantime, we didn't have to have that expense. So
that's excellent.
That's awesome. Okay, and finally, what is one tip, each of you, if that's okay, that you could share with folks who are interested in maybe just general RV travel, full-time, long-term, however you want to do it, that you've learned already that you think is helpful, would have been helpful for you to know when you first were getting into this experience?
I'm going to say we actually listened to our friends when we asked this, and it is to go slow. It is so important. I said I think we ended up being very fortunate the way things happened, where we ended up, you know, getting our rig in the middle of the pandemic. We ended up having to learn it on our own. We had that year before to, and then we moved into it and then stayed in one place, learning how to actually live in it before we started traveling, and not adding that added stress of, oh, now we're in a tiny spot and we're traveling. Let's figure out all the stresses at once. But then we took our time and stayed at places for like a week, and now a month at a time, and now we're going to start traveling again. But to actually learn how to live in it instead of just go, I think really helped.
That's a great tip.
Do
you
have another
folks.
Tip, Joel? Yeah. Or do you say?
Yeah, it's kind of on the slow down piece. On travel days, one of our things is, you know, especially with me, is like, we got to get up, we got to get moving, we got to get going. And, you know, if you don't follow your plan, when mistakes happen. So we have snap bracelets that go around the steering wheel.
I saw that. It's very unique. Yeah. Again, you show that, I think, on your channel, and that's something you're going to want to check out. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, so even though we have a list,
Deb
kind of does some things in the rig. I do the stuff on the outside, and then we each walk through. She walks around, and then I walk inside. And then the last thing before I pull out is I take those snap bracelets off to make sure that everything that we wanted to get done is done. And it's just the important stuff, like make sure you're unplugged and all that stuff.
You've got your wife on board.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, definitely have the wife on board.
But he says, yes, make sure you're unplugged. We've seen people driving down the road and they didn't unplug. They're dragging their cord.
Yes.
We've seen people with their antennas still up.
I've seen a lot of that.
So these things that seem like they're mundane or whatever, they aren't. Believe me, even the most experienced RVer can make the mistake.
Yep.
Yes. We've seen awnings still out.
We've seen even where they put their jacks up, but the jacks, for whatever reason,
didn't go
all the way up. And so people were driving not realizing that their jacks were not completely retracted. So, yeah, that's both of those tips, I think, are extremely important because, too, a lot of times people are so excited to get out there and start going, exploring. They wear themselves out right away because they do too much too quickly.
Yeah.
So great tips. Now, where can folks connect with you?
We are obviously on our YouTube channel, and we're on Facebook and on Instagram, and we just kind of started a TikTok. I'm trying to figure that out.
So is it the same name on
all platforms? We are Chasing RV Sunshine.
And we'll put links to all of those in the description of this video so you can easily jump over, say hi, make sure you hit subscribe, join their adventure, ask any questions.
Hey, they're getting close to 1,000,
y'all.
Let's get
them there.
Get over there. Let's get them there. Yes.
Well, thank you guys for having us on. It's been a joyous day.
Oh my gosh, we've had so much fun getting to know y'all in person. We followed you online for a bit, so now to get to actually sit down while y'all have been here as well has been just really a ton of fun.
Yeah.
We feel like YouTube geeks. We're so excited to be on this because we think we've seen every single one of your wingets.
Well, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
And thank you for watching. Make sure you also leave a comment if you have a question, if you guys would check the comments and, you know, answer any questions
that
folks have. Keep on winging it. We'll see you next time. Safe travels.
And happy camping.
Bye.